All right, guys, we're back for another Dokkan Battle video. Today, we're going to go and take AGL Trunks into the Legendary Vegeta event. AGL Dokkan Fest Trunks is very, very good. And one of the main things that our boy has got that's going to allow him to completely dominate the Legendary Vegeta event is this right here, Saiyan Lineage. Saiyan Lineage is a ridiculous link for the Hybrid Saiyan team. And the Hybrid Saiyan team in general is just insane. Here's the thing about the Hybrid Saiyan team, right? I would argue the pure Saiyan team is the best team in the game, probably, right? Which is just like the pure power of the roster, I just think is a little bit crazy. Again, the pure power of the pure Saiyan team is just ridiculous. You're just going to destroy everything, right? But the Hybrid Saiyan team, that is the team that probably has the most utility. The support and the, like, defensive stacking, like, you have all these characters, like, GT Trunks and Goten, you have GT Gohan and Goten, the STR Trunks, AGL Kid Gohan, like, look at the team I'm bringing right here, right? This is going to be so smooth. It is impossible for Vegeta to damage us, basically. The only conceivable way we could die in this event with this build right here is specifically if Evolution Blue Vegeta supers Trunks and then attacks him 10 times after. That's actually the only possible way we could die. If I play things correctly. I'm going to put Trunks inside one right here. 162k defense right there. Remember, he's getting 100% when he attacks, so he's well over 300k defense by a long shot. And then he gets 30% defense on Super. It's like, I feel like the way Trunks is built, the way his Super Saiyan form looks, it was easy when he came out for people to sort of be like, oh yeah, he's not really too crazy. But again, base Trunks here will flat out dominate in pretty much all content. Just the way he's built is, like, really, really, really good. I'm going to let this Trunks chill with this AGL LR Gohan for a little bit and sort of stack up a bit, right? The good thing is that STR Trunks, he does stack up fast as hell, man. Like, it really is only a few super attacks and his defense, like, explodes up. So we don't have to worry about him. Let him get a couple of super attacks. I don't want to transform with Trunks, but I probably will, because it's like, during Trunks' world tour, this is probably the only time I'm ever going to be really transforming with Trunks. It's just to kind of get, like, the OST and the voice acting and stuff like that and the animation in the video. But, like, you actually have no reason ever currently in the game to transform with Trunks. There's like, unless the only time you would ever transform with Trunks, ever, is if you get very, this Gohan is not rainbowed, so let's go ahead and have him super attack right there. The only time you'd ever transform with Trunks is, you know, maybe like in the future, right? Like, there's like Savior Extreme Super Battle Road. Because the final enemy in there is Omega Shenron, right? Omega Shenron and Savior Category Super Battle Road. Like, when that's an extreme version, that Omega Shenron's gonna have like 50 million HP or some crazy shit like that, right? He's gonna just be a juggernaut, like invincible. Maybe there you would be able to transform with Trunks, because Trunks has to do 6 attacks from the transform. You know, so you transform with Trunks, and then after Trunks has transformed, right, his transformation, like, his active skill is powerful, because it's not just that he turns into Super Saiyan, but he also stuns and seals the enemy. So, you know, in the future, the transformation could have value in Super Battle Road Sages, or maybe if you're like a free-to-play player. I mean, a lot of you guys are very quick to comment on the video, well, not everyone has rainbowed units like you, so I'm always blah, 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 blah. It's like, all right, cool, yeah, you know, maybe I beat the stage faster than you, that's fine. But you still have to attack 6 times with Trunks in a Super Battle Road run, where it's not like guaranteed. It's not just like, oh, I made it to turn 5 or 6. Trunks, you know, is going to transform now. It's like, dude, are we not on turn 6 right now? How many times has Trunks attacked? Once? Are we on turn 6 with Trunks having attacked once or some shit like that? Like, that's just how this goes. Like, that's why these conditions where you have to attack are pretty ass, honestly. And by the way, Trunks and Gohan work really well together. Cold Judgment, Saiyan Lineage, Fierce Battle, that's all you need, right? That's a very strong sort of core right there. GT, Trunks, and Goten, of course, supporting Vegeta family and Goku family is just so freaking... It's so goddamn ridiculous. That unit is so ridiculous. Like, it's insanity to me. Insanity that they released GT, Trunks, and Goten, and 5 months later, they dropped Tech Piccolo. What? Dude. Like, it's just, like, it's nuts. It's just, it's absolutely crazy to me that, like, again, they dropped GT, Trunks, and Goten, and then months and months later, they give us dog shit like Tech Piccolo. Even this STR Trunks right here is just so freaking good, right? What is his defense up to? Actually, he's only at 228k right there. Okay, so I do want to keep... We want to keep him stacking up like this for now. That STR Trunks is pretty much the best friend of the AGL Trunks. The one thing we'd need... STR Trunks would be a little bit better if we had one more powerful, like, Cell Saga era Gohan, right? Because it's like... Just personally, when it comes to running, like, the Hybrid Saiyan team and, like, these types of builds, I could run, like, LR Tech Super Saiyan 2 Gohan or LR Int Super Saiyan 2 Gohan, and, like, they would work incredible on these teams, right? They work very fine. They dominate. It's not, like, really what I'm going for with the team. I like this super heavy turtling. Like, I would like another, like... Top, honestly, I want like a top tier Super Saiyan 2. Okay, so here we are. We did 6 attacks on turn 8. We're able to transform. There's like actually no benefit to transforming. If anything, I mean, transforming. Well, I mean, he still keeps. The only link that changes is Saiyan Warrior Race becomes Super Saiyan. So it's like we could transform. He's better in base. For now, I'm going to keep him like this. And it's like, even against like Evolution Blue Vegeta, this Trunks is going to have a much better shot against Evolution Blue Vegeta in base. I mean, a little bit of his RNG, right? Because we need him to, you know, super attack multiple times, maybe even 3 times. But again, it's very common for Trunks to super twice. I would say that's a ridiculously common occurrence, is for Trunks to get 2 super attacks in. And if he gets that second super, like, Super Saiyan Trunks is not... I don't think his defense is, like, as good. So, that's something to keep in mind. All right, I think at this point, I'm going to go ahead and float off our boy Trunks. We'll go ahead and get him next to the other Trunks. And then we'll transform when they're together. And what do we have? I mean, we have, like, nearly every link active. It's close, right? When the two of them are together. What do they have, like, 6 links together or something like that? And I'm gonna transform into Super Saiyan Trunks, mostly because, in the future, like, you know, when I'm doing world tours for other units and I'm bringing this Trunks, I'm not gonna transform with this guy. So we'll take the opportunity to do it now. Again, remember Trunks. He'll work good against Evolution Blue Vegeta, but if Evolution Blue Vegeta supers AGL Trunks and then does many attacks after that, like, it's death. Because in order to survive Super or Evolution Blue Vegeta's Final Flash, you do pretty much have to be a defensive stacker. Well, it's very specific, right? Like, you can tank a super attack from him. That's not an issue. The problem is when Vegeta then attacks you 50 times, like, after he supers. That's where no unit outside of a defensive stacker can take that, right? Even LR Janemba, the best defensive unit in the game, if he does not get the super attack nullification off, he will take a lot of damage. I'm talking about fully built up LR Janemba, best defensive unit in the game. If he does not get the super attack nullification off, so if Vegeta still gets a defensive debuff applied, you're probably dead if Vegeta attacks Janemba like 10 times after supering him. There's Trunks going absolutely crazy. Look at this guy, dude. Like, Like, you see how impressive he is? Like, his defense is so crazy because he gets 30% defense on every super attack. Right? So it's like, he's at like 320k defense, and then he does 30% defense three times. It's essentially how that works. Right? Because it's like, he doubles his defense. Well, no, what does he get? He gets 100% defense on attacking. So he doubles his defense, and then he gets 30% defense three times. Like, he's just so stupid. I'm going to let these two chill. The only thing is I want to make sure that all these characters are defensive stacking and not just some of them. All right, so on this next turn, we're going to transform with Trunks. We'll see the rotation. We'll go ahead and let Trunks do some damage. I just really don't understand, like, you know what really would have actually fixed Trunks, honestly, like Super Saiyan Trunks? He should do a guaranteed additional super attack. I think that would fix him. Like, that's all it takes. Because, remember, his first turn, he's guaranteed critting. So, you would double guaranteed crit with Trunks on his first turn when he goes Super Saiyan. That, I think, would actually fix, like, the design mistake they made with him. Because, again, the mistake is that he doesn't get the additionals, whatchamacallit. The mistake is that he doesn't get the additionals when he's a Super Saiyan. Here, let's go ahead and pop this. We'll let this turn play out. Alright, so now we have our boy Trunks. We got 6 out of 7 links active, 151k defense right there. He does get 100% on super attack, right? And then he's also going to get 50% after the 100%. So his defense is like still like 400k plus. Like you know, don't get that twisted, but you guys get what I'm saying. This first attack is a guaranteed crit by him. He gets buffed if the enemy is like debuffed. But, like, by the time you transform with him, enemies are immune to that, typically, so it's just very bizarre. 5.37. I mean, that's good. It is good because it's a guaranteed crit. So, like, that's a lot of damage. Like, LR Tech Gogeta is doing similar attack stats with super effective against all types and then a 70% chance to crit. And I'm like, slurping his cock. Like, dude, Gogeta's... Oh, my God. 76K? Wow, that's very impressive. Dude, this blue Vegeta hits really hard. This blue Vegeta is way stronger than the Int Super Saiyan 4 Goku in the GT Legendary Goku event. He's way stronger. So that was really impressive by Super Saiyan Trunks right there. But again, like, remember, his damage is good. It's just like there's so many like negatives to getting there. He should be more powerful with how finicky it is to actually transform into that Super Saiyan version. And then again, if base Trunks triple supers, I feel like he's better than Super Saiyan Trunks, right? All right, let's go ahead and skip to Evolution Blue Vegeta now. We'll see how nasty Evolution Blue Vegeta is going to be towards us, if we could just go ahead and dominate him or what. You know, let's actually play this turn out. I was going to just skip ahead to Evolution Blue Vegeta, but again, let's go ahead and see this turn. 176k right here. Again, he's very good. Like, he is good, right? Because it's like, again, he's like rocking like 500k defense after he super attacks right here. Like, you know, he's impressive. I mean, I've got the team build specifically to make him look at his best. Yeah, see, like 6.27 right there. It's got a 70% chance to crit. Like, you know, you'll see people calling him bad. He ain't bad, right? Like, this, he shits on, I don't know. He's more impressive than Kefla in terms of damage, is he not? Like, I was pretty impressive right there. Because, like, Kefla can do really good damage, but you need 6 orbs, whereas Trunks is just, like, critting and stuff. Like, I think Kefla, you know, they're the best unit in the game for long events, but Trunks is definitely more... Yeah, Trunks is probably just outright better than Kefla, isn't he? Because upon using him a lot, he feels better. He feels way better in base, not even close. And I feel like he's better in his Super Saiyan. It's just that Kefla can be such a tank by that point, and she heals when she transforms, and it's easier to transform with her. There's pros and cons to each. Kefla has a way better leader skill, not even close. Base Kale and Khalifa have a way better link set, but Super Saiyan Trunks has a better link set, I think, than Super Saiyan Kefla. It's tough. There's a lot of pros and cons between the two. These last two turns by Super Saiyan Trunks were pretty insane, though. Like, that... he took 70k from this Vegeta. That was... Trunks is not bad. He's not bad, dude. Alright, so here we are against Evolution Blue Vegeta. It certainly does help us here that we do have Kid Gohan on rotation, right? So, dude, Trunks' defense is like 600k or something like that. I would love to see Vegeta's final flash. I should have brought the scouter item. Damn it. I gotta remember to start doing that for these. Because, like, Evolution Blue Vegeta, the entire gimmick of this entire event is 100% on this guy's super attack, right? Like, that... Oh, this is good. I don't think he supered last turn. Here we go. Okay. We would live. Remember, the reason it's so scary, it's not the damage the super does, but follow-up hits after is what makes it so scary. Damn it. Okay. All right. Because, again, it's an 80% defensive cut, right? Stack defense is not really affected by that. So, you know, the best characters to use are, you know, characters that stack defense. So, like, watch. Kid Gohan will take damage right here. You know, that's a lot, but he's not going to take damage from the normal attacks, right? Because he has stack defense. Typically... characters that don't have stack defense, like, we would have died right there. Like, that's the way that goes. I mean, there you guys go. Dude, Trunks is not bad. Trunks is good. It's, like, it's weird. It's, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like the more I've used him, he is better than Kale and Khalifa. Like, his base form, I think, is way better than Kale and Khalifa. It's not even close. Although their link set is better. Their leader skill is better. Their team is better, right? Their categories are better as well, I would say. Yeah, Kale and Khalifa have a lot more relevant teams than Trunks does. But, like, Trunks' performance is just outright better, probably in both forms. It's just that Kefla is, like, you know, untouchable if you're stacking with her for a while. She's so good. She's better defensively than Trunks a lot. Like, transform Kefla if she's stacking. I mean, so is base Kale and Khalifa after a couple of turns as well, too. But one thing I love about Kale and Khalifa, turn 6 is not a good active skill condition, but it's always turn 6, and there's no other requirements. It's just turn 6. There's no other requirements. The reason all of these, like, do X amount of attacks or something like that, the reason those suck is because there's no consistency. You have no idea. It could be turn 9, it could be turn 3, but you don't know. I really like it when you can account for when you're getting these abilities. And Trunks is definitely, like, I mean, you don't want to transform with him anyway, probably, but... Like, it's kind of just, like, you know, here and there. I don't know. Trunks looked crazy on this Hybrid Saiyan team to me. Like, this was insane. He's just so strong here. But it's the Hybrid Saiyan team. They make any unit look good. So let me know what you guys think. Thanks for watching. I'll catch y'all next time.